What is up, budget billers? My name is Trail, and today we have some unexpected news from Senator Joe Manchin as the House and the Senate return back to Washington from another recess break. Manchin continues to be a thorn in the Democrats' butts, but Joe Manchin met with Senator Bernie Sanders and Representative Pramila Jayapal on Monday to discuss what needs to be done to restart the negotiations on the reconciliation bill. And we also have a video clip from Jayapal's messages regarding the support of President Biden's Build Back Better plan. Now, in addition to that, Joe Manchin is now providing additional requirements or demands for the revised stimulus bill, which is pretty shocking to say the least, considering he's already caused the bill to fail. Now, those are just some of the topics that we are going to cover today, but if this is your first time to the channel, hey, welcome and glad to have you. On this channel, we talk about finance, real estate, credit cards, Bitcoin and crypto, stimulus update news, as well as money. So if you're interested in any of those, go ahead and hit the subscribe button for me. That way you can join our community. Also, if you end up liking the content in this video or even laughing at one of my corny jokes, then be sure to like this video. Other than that, guys, hey, let's go ahead and jump right into the video. Okay, guys, starting off today with a little bit of sad news. The former Secretary of State, Colin Powell, has died on Monday due to COVID complications. Now, he was 84 years old, but Powell was vaccinated against COVID, which has caused some people to lash out against the vaccine, saying that it does not work. But the issue with Powell was that he suffered from a cancer that makes the vaccine shots less effective. Now, this article right here talks about Colin Powell had been treated for a cancer that severely impairs his immune system, lowering the vaccine effectiveness. In this article, Powell was 84 years old and he received his second Pfizer shot in February, but was immune compromised as a result of his cancer and suffered from Parkinson's disease. Multiple myeloma is a blood cancer that severely impairs the immune system, lowering the effectiveness of vaccines. He was actually scheduled to receive his booster shot when he fell ill last week. He couldn't go to his appointment, but he thought he was just not feeling quite right, and he went to the hospital. So yeah, considering Powell died from COVID complications doesn't mean that the vaccine does not work. In his particular situation, what he was already getting treated for, his cancer treatment, actually reduced the effectiveness of the vaccine that he received from Pfizer. Also in the news, former President Bill Clinton was finally released from the hospital on Sunday, where he was dealing with an infection. Former President Bill Clinton was released from the hospital on Sunday. Former President Bill Clinton has been released from the California hospital after being treated for an infection that spread into his bloodstream. Clinton walked out arm in arm with his wife and the former Secretary of State, Hillary Clinton, before greeting hospital staff and giving a thumbs up when asked how he was feeling. Now, for those that don't know, Clinton had been admitted last week to the UC Irvine Medical Center intensive care unit for a urinary tract infection that spread to his bloodstream. The former president, who was in good spirits throughout his treatment, had been treated in the ICU for privacy and safety, not because he needed intensive care, according to his doctors. Bill Clinton is 75 years old. Now, guys, in regards to the stimulus package, we have a video clip that I want to share with you from Representative Pramila Jayapal. She is the Progressive Caucus Chair, and she talks about the efforts that they are doing in her caucus to stand up and support President Biden's agenda, the Democratic agenda, the Build Back Better plan. Go ahead and check it out.
Hey, everyone. It's been another big week here in Washington, D.C. And of course, the big ticket item is the ongoing negotiations around the popular Build Back Better Act. As chair of the Congressional Progressive Caucus, I am so proud to be leading the charge to ensure that we deliver on President Biden's entire agenda. That means investing in roads and bridges, but it also means investing in people and our communities. This bill is so important because it will make transformational investments that literally will change how working people and families across our country wake up every morning. It means 12 weeks of guaranteed paid leave, universal childcare, real climate action, pre-K, community college, housing, and healthcare. It means not leaving behind women or working families or immigrants. It means delivering on President Biden's agenda, the Democratic agenda, and what we all promised people throughout America when they gave us the House, the Senate, and the White House. That's why I'm spending so much time negotiating and holding the line on our popular priorities, because we need to pass this legislation to deliver for you. So stay tuned. I'll be sure to keep you updated as things move forward.
So yeah, Jaya Paul is the chairman of the 96-member Progressive Caucus, and she listed out all of the things that they are trying to get done with the larger stimulus package, mind you, $3.5 trillion, while also explaining how it is going to be for the American people. But unfortunately, President Biden has already stated that they will be reducing the price of the bill in order to get the votes of Joe Manchin and Christine Sinema. And now Joe Manchin is laying out some of his demands on the stimulus bill? Does he have the nerve? Joe Manchin is laying down some of his demands for the stimulus bill. And right now, these particular demands are in relation to the child tax credit. Senator Joe Manchin has reportedly laid down new red lines for the Democrats' multi-trillion dollar reconciliation bill, and this time making demands regarding the expanded child tax credit provision. Axios reported on Sunday that, citing people familiar with the matter, that Manchin informed the White House that the child tax credit must have an established work requirement and a family income limit in the $60,000 range if the Democrats want his vote for this package. Now, those demands would significantly weaken the child tax credit, which is one of President Biden's key programs to assist working families. It would also bring down the price tag of the spending bill, which Manchin and fellow moderate Senator Christine Sinema have both said is just too high. Now, progressives, however, are unlikely to get on board with the scaled-back version of the child tax credit, according to Axios. Manchin has previously called for work requirements for the child tax credit in addition to means testing to place a cap on the income of people who receive benefits under this program. And I must say, guys, that I do agree, because me being a six-figure person, I still get these child tax credits right now. Now, I don't get the full amount, but I still get a piece of it. And personally, I don't think that I should be receiving any portion of this child tax credit. But that's just my opinion. Now, Manchin told reporters last month that he wants requirements for everything, means testing and work requirements. On September the 12th, Manchin told CNN's Dana Bash that while he supports the child tax credits and he is trying to help the children, he wants to make sure we're getting it to the right people. There's no work requirements whatsoever. There's no education requirements whatsoever for better skill sets. Don't you think if we're going to help the children that the people should make some effort? Now, Manchin did, however, signal that he was willing to support Biden's $450 billion initiative to subsidize daycare and provide free universal preschool, sources told Axios. He reportedly wants tighter income caps to be placed on daycare subsidies, but to keep preschool free. Right now, the Democrats are looking towards reducing the price tag of the bill in order to meet the demands of Senators Joe Manchin and Christine Sinema. And Manchin is trying to get more things reduced in the process by giving out his own demands on what he thinks should be done. But obviously, that's to get his vote, right? We also have that Joe Manchin met with Senator Bernie Sanders and Representative Premier Jayapal on Monday. Right here, Joe Manchin met separately Monday with Senator Bernie Sanders and Congressional Progressive Caucus Chairman Pramila Jayapal as liberals and centrists in the party struggle to cut a deal on President Biden's sweeping spending plan. The meeting met first with Jayapal and then later with Sanders, come as the two leading progressives have grown increasingly frustrated with Manchin, a key holdout on the social spending bill that is still being negotiated. Now, while Sanders and Manchin have spent days in a high-profile battle over the spending legislation, which is the centerpiece of Biden's legislative agenda, the two men were on friendly terms as they left the Capitol and paused for a photo outside while surrounded by a gang of reporters. Manchin said, get a picture. You want to get a picture of me and Bernie Sanders? He told reporters, and then he called Sanders over so that they can take a picture together. And here, right here, is that picture that they took where Manchin put his arm around Bernie Sanders. Now, I don't know about you guys, but it doesn't look like Bernie Sanders is too happy right now to be featured on a photo with Joe Manchin. But it seems from their comments stating that they are willing to work together. And then while he was putting his arm around him, Joe Manchin said that we're talking, we're working this thing out. And then Sanders said, telling reporters that we're talking and that he's optimistic congressional Democrats and the White House would be able to work out an agreement on the social spending bill. He said, I would hope that we're going to see some real action within the next week or so. We discussed the way forward. Now, as Manchin and Sanders broke apart to go to their respective cars, Manchin called out, never give up, Bernie, never give up. So yes, guys, it appears that Bernie Sanders and Joe Manchin met on Monday and they are agreeing to work with one another until they can figure this thing out. Now, the Democratic-controlled House and the Senate will have only 10 more legislative days to meet the October 31st deadline to pass both the $1.2 trillion bipartisan infrastructure bill and the social spending bill, or the reconciliation bill, which was originally projected to be $3.5 trillion. But now, it is looking more like to only be around $2.2 trillion. Now, both the House and the Senate lawmakers return today, and they are busy trying to make all of this happen before that deadline. We are going to start seeing every day what provisions get removed from the bill and what provisions they will try and keep in the bill. We will sure to get updated news regarding these provisions sometime today as well as throughout the week, so be sure to stay tuned. But anyways, guys, hey, my time is up for today. Now, if you enjoyed this content and you want to see more, hey, go ahead and subscribe to the channel. It's totally free, guys. And if you enjoyed this video, go ahead and hit the like button for us. It definitely helps out a lot, and it also tells YouTube to share this video with others. Anyways, hey, I appreciate you guys stopping by and watching, and I hope to see you on the next video. Peace.